Yeah, it is a beautiful fall feeling today, right? We're going to get started. So we're going to be on the back of our chair. We're going to start with the massage ball under the foot. And we're just going to very gently start to press in and out of it. Thanks for joining me. I'm Juliana, and today I'm here at the Zakim Center for this chair yoga flow. Press firmly into the ball, moving it to your heel. And as you exhale, soften and bring it back to your toes. Looks like the camera adjusted the zoom there. Back and forth. Very gently pressing, going to the heel. And as you exhale, soften and come back to your toes. We're going to leave the ball on the ball of the foot and just play here with the toes. So do a little gripping, little flaring, and maybe a little side-to-side movement. Just starting to notice. You can always add more or less pressure depending on how you feel. It's a good practice to start to release the fascia in the bottom of the foot. Help to wake up the nerve endings for helping with the peripheral neuropathy, feet, and also arthritis, moving up those joints, loosening things up. Now getting a little closer to the heel. And when you come to your heel, the ball of the foot becomes your anchor, so you can move a little side to side, finding a little bit more support there. And when you feel ready, coming down and just noticing the difference between right and left before we start the other side. So take a inhale and press going to your heel. And as you exhale, soften, come back to your toes and just starting to feel those sensations. Bottom of the foot, noticing how this side feels compared with the other. We're going to start to stay with the ball of the foot. The toes, the gripping, the rolling, adjusting the pressure. Maybe adding more or less. And just start to get into your arch. And eventually we're going to come closer to the heel. As you come closer to your heel, maybe coming like a high heel shoe, do a little side-to-side movement there. And we're coming down, noticing again, right and left. Should feel a little bit more grounded, more supportive. We're going to start to come to the chair. So take your time to find your seat. We're going to need maybe a strap today, a couple blocks. So as we bring our feet to the floor, if your chair is a little high and you can't touch the floor, you just bring the blocks or a blanket or something under your feet so you can find that full support. Let yourself rest all the way back. And bringing your hands to your thighs, start to release your shoulders down. Take a nice deep breath in and a big sigh. Letting go of tension, of stress, of drama. Inhaling through the nose. Big sigh through the mouth. Just really letting go. Next one, inhale. Huge sigh. Perhaps even closing your eyes and just feeling your body empty of the stress, of anxiety, of fear. Now just inhaling and exhaling through your nose, starting to soften deeper. And you start to scan from the top of the head down, relaxing the body, softening. Feeling the feet rooting into the earth. The support beneath them grounding, helping you to create roots, to feel supported, relaxed, and safe. Connection with the earth element brings a sense of well-being, of safety. And relax even deeper now, noticing the sit bones also releasing into the chair supporting you so you can continue to relax your legs and also helping you to lengthen your spine. Sit bones down and spine lengthening up, crown of the head reaching up to the heavens. And you feel your head resting over the heart and the heart resting over the hips. Everything is stacked up nicely, so it's easy to hold without too much effort. You can soften even deeper. Relaxing the corners of the eyes, the cheeks, the jaw. Perhaps even moving your jaw a little side to side. A yawn might come out of it. And feel that release of the shoulders, the elbows and fingertips, as you notice your heart light and the belly soft. And just noticing the stillness of the body. And now starting to notice the movement of the breath. Perhaps even allowing one hand to rest on your belly. And just noticing it rising and fall as you inhale. Feeling that spreading. As you exhale, the softening, releasing, and letting go. And then start to notice the pauses between the inhalation and the exhalation. Just noticing how the breath's starting to get longer and deeper, smoother. And the mind starts to follow as well, calming down, quieting. And that's what we're looking for. Little bit of pause between the thoughts. You find that pause, you can take that deeper breath. And with that deeper breath, making better decisions, reacting better and feeling better. If you feel there's too much going on, allow yourself to come back to your breath. To help you to connect to the here and now. Your next inhale, take your hands one over the other, over your heart, and breathe in the gratitude of being here today. It brings you joy, a beautiful fall day, nice sky, a meal, a light conversation. Anything that sparks that light in your heart, breathe it in. And then this light planting the seed of your intention. What is your heart's deepest longing? Let it settle in. And gently bowing your head to your heart. And then very slowly releasing your hands down. As you inhale, roll the heads of the shoulders up and back. Blink your eyes open, and when you feel ready to move, we're going to move to the center of the chair. I'm going to take one of those blocks and put it between my legs, firming and engaging a little bit more the inner legs. Focus this week is more of grounding poses, so a lot of legs and connection with core. So finding that grounding of the feet, roll the heads of the shoulders back. Inhaling and exhaling. Start to add those fingertips. Elbows up, side and down. So you can take, again, your own range of motion. Maybe start to take it even deeper by releasing your arms down and then slowly drop your chin into your chest. Inhale, roll your left ear to your left shoulder. And as you exhale, roll your chin into your chest, right ear to the right shoulder. You're drawing that little smiley face with the tip of your nose and hold it here on to the left. And just playing with the angle of the head, upside and down, just noticing the sensations there. And as you exhale, roll your chin into your chest and pause onto the right. And just moving the head slightly, can you feel the different sensation on the side of the neck? And then roll your chin into your chest. And when you feel ready, grounding through your feet, your sit bones, you reach up, lift up. Wherever up is for you, as you exhale, turn your palms out like you're pushing through thick air. Control that movement. Inhaling, put your hands come closer together and then slowly bring it to your heart. You're going to pause here, locking the fingers and doing a little pumping. Start to look over one shoulder and then the other, getting a little bit release into the neck. And from here, we're going to slowly start to take it up and up and up. Ground through the feet, reach it up and start to add a little side to side movement. Can you feel more opening through the side body? Release the hands. You start to take it up and over, like you're brushing rainbows up onto the ceiling with the tips of your fingers. And next time your left hand is to the chair, stay there. Let the right arm go up. Bring that hand behind the head. Really, again, exploring it here. It could just be the shoulder, it could be the elbow, it could be the full arm, really opening. Make it yours, make it work for you. Hand comes behind the head. Inhale, lift the heart. Maybe revolve that shoulder slightly back and you feel that deeper opening through the side. Take one more breath in. And with your next exhale, let your head be guided over to the right. Relax your left shoulder. It's really good. That shaking for the joints and release. And bring that arm across. Inhale, lift your heart. Roll the fingers, keep them moving. And then taking that arm one under the other. Start to lift your elbows in a self-hug, finding your eagle arms here or the backs of the hands. You can add a deeper twist to that thoracic spine by looking over one shoulder and the elbows going the opposite. Inhale, exhale, release. Hands to the thighs, cat-cow your spine. Opening your sternum, your heart, and as you exhale, rounding, tail dropping between the legs. Inhale, slide the hands back, squeeze the elbows, round it back. Last time you inhale, you're gonna take your arms up to the sky, and you're gonna let your right hand come down to the chair. Hold it here. And again, you can start to play with the shoulders, the elbows softening, loosening it up a little bit more. Find what works here for you. Maybe that hand comes behind, you revolve. Take a nice deep breath in. And as you exhale, slowly let your head be guided over to the left. Relax your right fingers and shoulders. And then sweep that arm across, just like you did on the other side, bringing that arm close by where the fingers see it moving. And perhaps taking that hand to the neck and shoulders, giving a gentle massage there. It's starting to get a little colder, right? So maybe you start to feel that you're kind of rolling yourself into a little ball at night. And then from here back in front of the hands, you can look over one shoulder and then to the other side. Inhale, let your elbows reach up. Exhale, start to pull them in, hands to the thighs, cat-cow your spine once again. Beautiful. Inhaling. Next time you go back, we're going to start to circle. So again, take your circles in any form or way that works for you. You can take it smaller bit. Next time you're back, reverse the direction you're moving into. You might even notice that one side feels a little easier than the other, right? So just noticing, that's a big part of the yoga practice. Next time you come back to the center, let your arms reach up, lift up. And as we exhale, we're going to find those cactus arms. So start to engage your core. Maybe even think about pulling like a bungee cord behind you. Inhale and exhale. Really feel those back muscles engaging. Take one more. And as you exhale, we're going to hold it here. Engage the core. Squeeze the block. Navel pulls in. And you're going to tip it to the right. Come back to the center. And then tip it to the left. Beautiful. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Beautiful. Come back to the center. And now as you exhale, we're going to close the elbows. Inhale, open. Exhale, pull them in. Can you feel a little bit more engagement of those back muscles? Inhale and exhale. Take one more time. Inhale. Exhale, pull the tips. Squeeze. Tap your hands for 3, 2, and 1. Take your arms all the way up. Great job. Roll your wrists. Flick your fingers. Roll the wrists. Flick those fingers. And now from here, we're going to very gently turn to the right. Let the hands land. So when you find the hands onto the side, I'm just going to turn it to the side so you can see. You're going to inhale, lengthen to your spine. As you exhale, maybe start to walk your hands a little further back. Inhale, lift. Keep that lifting of the heart. Exhale, maybe the shoulder will revolve. Last part will be the cervical spine, which is the neck. Maybe it looks bad. Only if it feels good. Inhale, take both arms up to the sky. And exhale, let it land onto the other side. Inhale, lift. Keep the length and exhale. Perhaps you go a little deeper. Inhale, lift. Exhale, maybe go a little deeper. Take one more breath here. Inhale. Exhale. Come back to the center. Inhale all the way up. And exhale, roll your wrists. Start to bring your hands, your palms together and start to create a little bit more heat. Nice. Warming up those hands. And then we're going to start to massage the heel of the palm. We start to move it up to the base of each finger. And again, just like you did on the feet, it's a good practice for neuropathy on the hands, arthritis as well. You're getting these nice acupressure points also in your hands as you start to squeeze to the tip of each finger, and then that pinching on the web of the fingers, right? Just noticing, usually there's one or two spots that feel a little bit more sensitive if you need to stay longer or revisit. All right, and then just give it a little shake. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Just starting again with the heel. Start to move it up to the base of the fingers. Now, one hand might feel slightly different or very different depending, right, what you've been doing. Just noticing those joints, right? And then we start to squeeze all the way up. Nice. Start to move all the way to closer to the tips of the fingers. And then giving that little pinching on the web. Just being aware again, right? If you need to modify the pressure, you need to hold it longer or less. And shake it out. All right. So I'm gonna stay with that block between the legs just to start to warm up the inner legs and core a little bit more. So when you feel that you're squeezing that block and you feel that your navel starts to engage a little bit more and your spine starts to lift. So we want to keep that engagement of the core. So squeeze the block and then soften. So it's isometric contraction. So you don't see the legs moving that much, but the muscles are contracting, staying in place. The fibers are still moving, contracting, but you don't see that big movement of the legs. Nice. Now I'm going to take the block from between the legs and I'm going to take it in front. I'm just going to start to take the feet off the floor. I'm starting to warm up a little bit more the quadriceps here. So every time you take your feet, I'm just going to turn it slightly to the side. You might be able to see better. Every time you take your feet off the floor, right, it's going to challenge your balance. When you challenge your balance, you work your core. So again, it could be less or it could be more. And again, also more quadricep work. You're going to have to engage your core a little bit more. And you're going to feel that your lower back has to support the whole thing. If you want to add those arms and curling, you can. And two and one. Now we're going to stay here and roll the shoulders back. Now, when we twist, we're going to twist from the shoulders. And then we're going to come back to the center. Inhale. And as you exhale, you twist from your shoulders. You inhale, come back to the center. If you want more, start to stand there. Tippy toes, start to hinge back without touching the back of the chair. So notice now you're taking into a deeper or lower V, right? You can always create these shapes. Last two. Last one. Come back to the center and just give it a little bit of a shake, moving the feet. Hands are going to be on the outside of the knees. Now we're going to do exactly the opposite. So if you didn't have your hands on your knees will go up. But keep your toes onto the floor. Don't let them flip up. Hold it here. Maybe a slightly hinging and engagement in the core. Press. Resist. And soften. Resist. Press into your hands. Hands pressing into the knees. And then soften. Two more. Press. Can you feel how your outer legs are starting to engage? How your arms as well. And relax it out. Great job. Now picking up that right foot, roll the ankle and take the other one. Roll the ankle. All right, I'm gonna stay with that right leg. Point and curl it back. Point and flex and curling like you're gonna kick your butt with your heel. One more. So you're starting to engage the hamstring and the knee joints. Hold it out there. Point, flex, and roll. All right. So now we're going to start to pulse. Getting a little bit more into the quadriceps for four. and three and two and one. I'm going to drop that heel down. If you want, you can use your strap, your towel, or your belt, whatever you have there, and hook it over. And if you don't have it, it's absolutely fine. You can just start to hinge from your hips without that. And that will be just kind of like you support yourself onto the other leg. Now soften the knees. Try not to lock it. No weight on that leg. It's your upper body releasing over that's going to increase that intensity with the spine nice and long. It's the curling of the toes, the pressing of the heel down and the hip pushing back. All these things will increase and spice it up a little bit more. With your next exhale, we're going to come up. So I'm just going to turn my chair back to the front again. And like anytime, like you're doing any exercise, if you feel that you need to take a break to take water, you can always do it. You don't have to wait for me. So start to feel that foot like hovering and just planing here. Maybe you start to take it a little bit more range of motion, right? You can keep even the leg a little bit more extended. Hold it, circle one way and maybe the other way. Great job. Let's bring it back to the center. I'm going to cross, switch the hands, and I'm going to slightly pigeon toe. So I'm going to turn my toes to the left, press with the heel, cross into that ankle. And as I inhale, lengthen the spine, and exhale, twist to the right. So now the twist starts to come from the shoulder down the side of the legs. Maybe you feel it a little bit on your IT band. We're going to drop that heel, cross. Now we're going to stay here with this crossed leg. So you can stay here and hug your knees, or you can hug one knee on top of the other and finding that little hugging of the legs and lifting of the spine. So we're setting up for eagle. And if you feel ready to add your majestic wings, you open them out. Your right comes under the left and you give yourselves a hug. Inhale, let your elbows lift. Now again, you can continue squeezing the elbows and squeezing the legs or the backs of the hands, whatever you chose here. Take a nice deep breath in. And as you exhale, just hinging slightly forward, nesting your eagle. Let your hands come to your thighs or shin. Now you might start to feel a little bit more on your hips. You can stay here. Some of you might bring that shin a little up higher with the hinge. We'll get deeper. Or you can come into that full figure four with the knee dropping further and away and the shin becoming more parallel to the floor. So just like a little triangle between your legs. It looks like a number four. You can always add a little circling. You can always rush the legs out and in just to help with that flow. You can do a tapping, a squeezing, right? There's no right or wrong. There's many ways that you can add a little bit more spice to your workout, to your class, to your practice. And as you exhale, we're going to come out of it. And we're just going to do a little windshield wiping of the legs. So we did a lot of work onto the back, the knees, but we're going to start to stretch a little bit more the quadriceps. So I'm turning over to the left. I'm going to step that foot onto the floor. Now, if it feels too high here that you need to put a block under it, you can always do that as well. But try to have that knee and ankle kind of like a line. And now from here, you start to play with this tucking of the pelvis. So the navel pulls in, the tail drops, the spine lifts. Can you feel that when that all happens, this really gets a really beautiful stretch into the front of those quadriceps. Now, if this feels too much, you can always let your knee be a little bit more softer forward. And you can just stay playing here on the chair or picking it up a little bit more by lifting up into this crescent lunge and going maybe a little up and down. Stay low. Engage the core, and maybe you take your right arm up and over. Take one more breath in. Exhale, release, come back down. Great job, guys. And just doing a little windshield wiping of your legs. Let your knees and toes point straight out, hands supporting you here. Inhale, take it up. Let's tip it over to the right. Inhale, center. Exhale, tip it over to the left. Nicely done. Bring yourself back to the center. Hands on the thighs, push your left hand in the middle of your left thigh and look over to the right shoulder, getting a little cheerleader squat here and then to the other side. Nice. Come back to the center, heel toe your feet and relax your hands. Pick up the foot, roll the ankle. I'm gonna stay with this march. I'm just gonna turn it to the side so you can see it better. Now staying with that left leg, up and down. Up and down. Now hold it here, point, and curl it back, point. Can you feel that you're working the hamstrings as you point, you curl it back? Nice, last one, we're gonna hold it out there, a little rolling. Now pulse it up, engage in your quadriceps a little bit more, core engaged, lower back engaged, drop it down. Inhale, lengthen your spine, grab your strap, your towel, anything that you might need there, and start to hinge. Again, you can stay a little bit higher, but trying to keep that back nice and long, core engaged. Relax the head and the shoulders, gazing down to your toes. Maybe curling your toes more, maybe pressing the heel and feeling that hip pushing back. All these little things that will add to it. Take one more breath in. And as you exhale, holding onto that strap and the knee, and start to open and close. Relax your shoulders. Let the legs start to move. Circle it. One way and the other. And again, it could be very small range of motion or bigger, your choice. We're gonna bring it back to the center. When we do, we're gonna switch the hands. So you're gonna start to cross and slightly pigeon toe. So when you turn your toes out, pressing with the heel, you're gonna start to feel a little bit more on your IT band. You can stay less, you can cross, you can add that twist by inhaling and exhaling, looking over that shoulder. Beautiful. When you come out of it, dropping that ankle, and just like you did on the other side, you choose. You wanna stay with the ankles crossed or the knees crossed. Find a little hugging and lifting. So you're not slouching, you lift. Especially with that hug, it's gonna help you to feel it more engaged. You take your left under the right, give yourself a self hug here or back of the hands or front of the hands, whatever you choose. Keep the elbows reaching up high, the hands moving away from your face to really feel that spreading into the back. You can relax the neck. And with your next exhale, you nest your eagle, start to fold over, release your hands and adjust. Now again, this already might be enough. If you need less, you come back up. If you need more, you start to bring that shin and start to hinge, or even allowing that knee to drop a little bit more to the side. And again, just noticing how does this side feel. Again, you can start to do a little brushing of the legs out and in. Even squeezing. Pressing up. You know your body better than anybody else. Just noticing how much you need here. All right, we're gonna drop it down. Do a little windshield wipe of the legs. Now we're gonna turn to the right. We're gonna start to stretch and straighten this left leg. So engage your core, navel pulls in, drop your tail, lengthen your spine, and feel that beautiful stretch, right? You can stay here. Or maybe you start to come up and down. So again, you can always stay seated on the chair and just playing with that, or coming up and down. 3, 2, and 1. Hold it, and perhaps you let your arm reach up and over. Can you feel that stretch? Take one more breath in, and exhale, slowly release, bring it down. Nicely done. Heel toe your feet, open your legs out wide again. So really focusing on anchoring and grounding here, right? Legs are really important. Toes and knees pointing in the same direction. Open your arms one more time. Now we're gonna start to build onto this goddess. We're gonna take it from one side. Inhale, exhale, and inhale. Next time you come to the right, you're gonna stay here with that hand. Maybe the other arm comes behind. Exhale, bring it down. Take your hands down to your left, your right thigh, and just move your shoulders and body away from it. Maybe that left arm comes out. So you're trying to create length here onto the side. You might feel comfortable already, and or you want to extend that leg, toes are slightly in, so almost like a warrior two. You can take that arm up and over, or back of the hand wraps to remind you to open into the shoulder, because you're not dropping down, you want to open up. It's an open twist. Now, if you feel that you want to come up a little higher, adjust your left foot and knee so it's pointing more to the side, same angle, so you don't let your knee flop in, firm it out. And as you inhale, the right hand pulls you into your warrior two. As you exhale, release that hand down. Inhale, maybe coming off your chair, an extended side angle. You can loosen that arm and inhale, come back into a warrior two. And then bringing that hand up and over. Maybe even extend through the front leg. Triangle. And as you exhale, you bend. Choose if you want to come back to your chair and just release it out. Open your legs and your knees, finding your goddess, and this time dropping it over to the left. Take that arm up behind the head, inhale, open. Like we did in the beginning, exhale, you point it down. Release that hand down, move it over. Start to find that length. Try to keep that length, right arm, forearm. Maybe you extend the leg. Now again, you can always stay here. You don't have to fully extend it. If you know that you're going to come off your chair, adjust that front leg and knee. Otherwise, stay where you are and comfortable. Reach that arm up, finding that open twist or the back of the hand. And then slowly let go and let your left hand pull you up into your warrior two. So you can choose if you want to stay on your chair or come off of it. Right hand comes to the chair. Inhale, extended side angle. Choose the conscious movement. And exhale, soften. Inhale, warrior two. Come back to the chair. Inhale, extended side angle. Maybe even reach it up like a triangle. And then slowly release. Warrior two. Returning back to your chair and moving it around. I'm going to take the block between the legs so we can start to come into chair pose. So more work spots here. So squats, again, things that we do every day. So just starting to feel that engagement of the inner legs as you squeeze. Keep the pressure on your heel. So you can do this behind your chair, holding the back of the chair. If you don't want to squat too low, you can start to take your hands forward. And if you're taking your hands forward, when you sit down, let your right arm reach back. You gaze that hand. Inhale, come back up. And as you exhale, you come back and you take that other hand back. Come up. And then back down. Come up. And then back down. This time we're going to come all the way up and take that block from between the legs. Give it a little bit of a shake. Come behind your chair for a down dog on the chair. Any formal way that this works for you. We're going to step back, soften the knees. And just letting that tailbone go back. Maybe you drop your head between your arms, if that feels good. If this feels too much for you to drop the head and you want to stay a little bit higher, you can let your forearms stay here. Or you can even let your forehead rest, right? You can choose what works for you today. Just take your time and move it slow. You can really feel as you move the head to one side, the sensation to the side body, the leg, and to the other side as well. Gently start to step your right foot forward, bend that right knee. A little bit of a runner stretch as you press through the heel, getting into the calves, the ankles. And then very gently start to come up. You're coming back into your crescent lunge. Find the reach of the arm up and over. If you prefer to do this seated, absolutely fine. Drop through the heel. Open your arms wide, beautiful. Start to feel the legs pulling in opposite directions. Let that hand or forearm come to the chair, maybe even the elbow support, and then you can take that extended side angle. Or even taking that arm all the way up and pushing into that leg, into your triangle. Open your heart still up to the sky. Exhale, release. Let that hand pull you back into your warrior two. And then very gently take it back to the center. Pedal your feet, move it around, and take it to the other side. So I'm just going to turn it around here. Maybe it'll work better. All right, so now you're pumping your right heel back. Now staying here. Maybe start to pick up that back knee. Coming into your crescent lunge. Hold it. You can take your right arm up and over, deepening that stretch. Take that hand to your heart. Drop that foot into an angle. And start to notice. Open it out. Front knee and toes are pointing in the same direction. Don't let it flop in. Let it stay firm. And you start to feel your legs and your chest opening to the long edge of your mat. Maybe this is where you stay. And if you like to come a little further, you can support the head. You start to reach an extended side angle. Maybe the arm up. And you can really reach into your triangle here. Find that opening, extending the legs. And exhale, slowly softening, release that hand. Inhale, you come back to your warrior two. And as you exhale, slide that foot back and you come back into your down dog until you slowly take your time to come up to your standing pose. So I'm going to take a block for the next one. So this is Tadasana Mountain with a block. So you're going to take your block and put it between your legs. Again, if you don't have a block, it could be a pillow. A book might be a little too heavy or awkward. I don't know. So the block at least has a little bit of cushioning, right? So what you want to feel here is the pressure on your heels. Your navel pulling in and spine lifting up as the tail drops down. So you're not arching, right? And think of, you know, those little Pez dispensers? It's almost like you're pushing your Pez dispenser forward. So the pressure is on the four corners of the feet, but the heels get really grounded. The navel pulls in, the spine lifts, and instead of having the Pez back, it moves slightly forward with that dropping of the tail. So really feeling those legs really engaged, really grounded. Relax your shoulders as much as you can. So now you're really stacked and strong like a mountain. The inner legs are really here to support you and lift you. And with your next exhale, soften. We're going to take the block from between the legs and still having that impression that the block is there, right? So it's that hugging of the inner legs that will help you to lift. And you can feel that you're maybe feel a little bit more grounded than normal. I'm going to take the block once again and just drop it down. I'm gonna do a tree with a block. So again, if you don't like the block, you can always take the block out of the way. But you're gonna start to shift the weight to your left and bring your right toes to that block. Try not to let your hips sway out. So it's that same sensation that there's a block there, you're grounding, you're rooting up. And maybe you take your arms up to the sky. Your branches starts to grow. If you feel that you want to add a little bit more, maybe you start to slide that heel up. Just be aware. And exhale, release. Let's try it on the other side. Firm. Toe. Press into that heel, into the shin, shin into the heel. So again, it's not out. It's that firming in. Just like if there was a block there, right? Lifting you up. Getting a nice, strong, supportive base to rise and shine, and then slowly release. Beautiful. And we're gonna start to find our seat. So as we find our seat here, we're gonna close with a square breath. Equal amounts of inhale, pauses, exhale, and pause. So I'm going to do a count of four. You guys kind of know this already by now. If you feel that you need to change the count, if it doesn't work for you, if it feels too stressful to hold into that pattern, just let it go. Do less, right? The last one, I'm just going to increase it for a count of two on the exhalation, just to make it slightly longer. Usually longer exhalations help to calm the body. So we're gonna bring the hands to the thighs, relax the shoulders down. One normal inhale and exhale to start. Inhale for four, three, two, one. Hold it for three, two, one. Exhale four, three, two, one. Pause four, three, two, one. Inhaling four, three, two, one. Hold it four, three, two, one. Exhale four, three, two, one. Pause four, three, two, one. Inhaling four, three, two, one. Hold it four, three, two, one. Exhale six, five, four, three, two, one. Hold it four, three, two. Normal inhale and exhale. Just feeling the breath getting longer, smoother, deeper. And how the mind also starts to quiet down. And starting to scan from the top of the head down. Start to soften the corners of your eyes, relax the cheeks and the jaw, and soften your tongue. Feel the release of the back of the throat, down the shoulders, the wrists, the fingers. Feel the heart light, the belly soft, and the hips heavy. Continue to relax down your legs, your knees, ankles, and toes. If you're happy where you are, you can stay where you are in the comfort and safety of your home. But if you feel like moving, start to wiggle the fingers and the toes, deepening the breath. And today we're going to close with a mudra called Purna Rajraya Mudra, or the Open Heart Mudra. You're going to take your palms together and just letting the fingers slightly lock here. You're going to turn your fingers in. Thumbs come together and you're forming that heart in front of your heart. That's the open heart mudra. You can close your eyes. And this mudra cultivates, embraces our feelings and thoughts. Helps with compression in the chest, with depression. And helps cultivate also the immunity and that quality of unconditional love of the heart chakra. And just feeling your body filled with healing energy and love. Bring your palms together, thumbs to the forehead, and we bow. Namaste. The light in me bows to the light in you. Thank you so much for joining me today. Hope you enjoy the rest of the day. Have a great rest of your day, weekend. Maybe I'll get to see you on Music Heal the Souls Festival this Saturday. I'll be there in person. Otherwise, I'll see you guys around and be well.